I'll be honest with you. I don't mind sharing the story. I auditioned for Ralph Cifaretto, and I was signed the contract. I did everything, and then when I got to set, it didn't seem like the chemistry was working out for me and James. I mean, they were dyeing my hair white and everything, and David wasn't too happy with everything. So, I did my best to keep going with it, but David didn't think it was the right fit, and James was telling me the same thing. David came up to me and he said, "What do you want to do?" I said, "I want to stay on the show, of course." James also. So they came up with the character Eugene Pontecorvo. Now that was hard to, that was really tough to live with as an actor, and I hadn't been doing it for quite some time, but I had the humility, to say, okay, I'm going to keep on going. I'm going to keep on keeping on, regardless of who knows, who doesn't know. It didn't matter to me. And I'm happy to share the story because I think it's a good example for, not quitting. And look how I ended up. I ended up with a really great episode and met a great bunch of friends and everything. And that's how it really happened to me,
And let me tell
so
you,
they created the role. They created Eugene for you.
So they,
That wasn't
so
all
I
him.
asked, I asked Terry. Yeah, they created Eugene. I asked them, who is Eugene? He said, we'll figure it out. Don't worry about it. And as well as I, as you went along, we went to the racetrack, the Breeders' Cup. There was the Breeders' Cup. We were playing basketball
Breeders'
in
Cup,
front of
yeah,
the,
that was
you
good.
know, the basketball in front of the place. The writers were very astute in the sense of hanging out with us, and
But
coming up with ideas.
Bobby, you
Yeah, yes, Stevie.
did you have to audition for Eugene?
No, I was
No.
just given,
They just gave
given,
things.
you just
Let me tell
created
you
role.
something. Let me tell you something, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart. You got giant fucking balls because somebody else, you were down on the fucking mat after that, and you got up and you built a nice career for yourself. And another guy would have fucking put his tail between his legs. He would have went home and fucking cried, poor me, poor me. What could have been? So good for fucking you is right. I mean,
Thank you,
I
Steve.
mean, honestly, and I'm not just saying that. That's big fucking balls. That was a blow.
Well,
That was a blow, you know.